All right, well, it's the end of 2 weeks of working here at Maddox Turbines, and let's take a look at what we've got done in those 2 weeks. Now, I didn't get a whole lot of footage because we were supposed to be working, but we had the LM500 sitting here, and I got a bit of footage of that thing before we started tearing it apart. The bits of me on the first day, the audio is pretty bad because I left the sound attenuating equipment on the camera immediately after that Avon test, so sorry about that, but the next clips we had the audio right.
Okay, we've got a bit of an oil leak. You see in there? Some crusty burnt oil poked up. And the residue was inside the center body. It's basically a fairing.
Look at that. Isn't that cool? An Avon in its natural environment. It wants to fly. 20,000 horsepower. 20,000 horsepower. And you built it.
Yes.
You are responsible. This is my little engine here. 5,000.
I love this baby.
Isn't it great?
I just worry about it.
Look at that thing. It wants to fly right now. Just put a couple little wings on it. Pull the Kickstarter. All right, let's get back to work.
There you go. Okay, apply the removing torque. What are we at now?
750.
Oh, 750. So we got the 750, 800. Mm-hmm. All right, that's good. Just to prove there's nothing in the middle of a jet engine. You can see all the way through.
Couple hundred bolts and you're done.
We dropped the locking pin, that's okay.
This way.
Look at that. That's the lock strip. Yeah, that's normal. It's just like that one right there. Good. Okay.
I'm going to put tape on that.
There's the compressor of the LM500.
See if we can get around the other side and see how much extra space there is around the blades and stators, i.e. next to none. There you go. Modern high technology engine. There's your space that you can fit through if you're a very small bird. Smaller than 1 millimeter wingspan. Let's see if we can turn this. Oh yes. There's a lock strip right there. See that thing? Yeah.
in the lower compressor half.
It's pretty clean. Very few deposits. And thankfully, no damage. Nothing needs to be fixed in here. Looking good.
But if it didn't have a thrust bearing in there, it would just slide down and contact the case. So, a little different from the engines we're used to. It's got a large ball bearing right there.
There we go, the outside of the compressor case with the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows of variable stators, and then the IGVs, which look like variable stators, but they're in front of the rotor. These rings, these are the actuating rings, they get moved. See that? See how they move? And what that does, let's move to the other side. Other side. I don't know if you can see this too well. Yep. There, you see that? That's how the variable stators change their angle. And change an angle. See that? There we go. Hey, this engine's a little weird because it has no midframe or center frame or center housing or whatever you want to call it. It's all part of the combustor inside. Look at how alien and freaky this is, all these oil lines. It's like it's alive. It's a modern high-tech engine. There's a roller bearing here. It goes to the back of the compressor shaft, the HP compressor shaft. And that roller bearing way down there supports the forward end of the HP turbine shaft. The reason there's two bearings is because between the two of them is where the two shafts join. Look at all those oil tubes. It's like it's inside a living metallic monster. Yes. And all that is inside the combustor outer casing. And there is no center casing or compressor rear frame or midframe or whatever you want to call it. I think that's pretty cool. Very efficient use of space.
So I tried to take some footage of us taking the engine apart and a little bit of removing the compressor, some bearing separation stuff, and I didn't really get as much as I wanted to, but that's the way it goes when you've got to work for a living. Anybody recognize that? That is from another Arenda. You recognize that? Yes, you do. There are the combustor inner liners. Here, oh, those are the compressor cases. Aren't they beautiful? Aren't they? And the combustor outer cases. Sometimes called cans. Appropriately in this case, they're combustor cans. There's the turbine. Okay, from Friday afternoon, actually it's Friday night, it's dark out there. From Friday night at Maddox Turbines in Fort St. John, British Columbia. Thanks for watching.